Since when do antiviral medications potentially help with the side effects of Parkinson's disease? That's what we're about to discover together in this latest installment of PD Medications, Purpose, and Mechanisms. And we're talking about amantadine. Without further ado, let's go. Welcome to the Parkinson's Disease Education Show, where we demystify the disease and empower you as the person with Parkinson's disease to reach your true potential. The content contained on this show is for informational purposes only and is not meant to be a replacement for information or advice that you receive from your in-person medical or therapy professionals. If you haven't already, I hope you'll consider subscribing. And for an even more personalized experience, please ask us about our memberships. Now, without further ado, let's start the show. So you heard me right. Amantadine was originally developed as an antiviral prescribed for influenza back in the 1960s. What they discovered was persons with Parkinson's disease responded really well to it when they took it. So as you may or may not know, one of the common side effects of Parkinson's disease, especially if you've had Parkinson's for many years, is something called dyskinesia. Dyskinesia is an involuntary movement, uncontrolled movement that tends to result most commonly with peak doses of dopamine. So when your medication, the dopamine is most effective or the highest dose, you tend to have more dyskinesia. Dyskinesias can be debilitating and, frankly, at the very least, very annoying. Where you have writhing movements going on, your head might be moving all over the place, it might be a limb, it might be a hand. There's no telling where the movements might be. It could be in any particular limb or region of the body. Regardless of location of the movement, though, amantadine has been found to be really effective in reducing those dyskinetic movements. So, what forms of amantadine are out there? Most commonly, you have your generic amantadine. Brand name you might find is Simitrel. There's a long-acting form of amantadine called Gocovri. It's basically just an extended-release version of that amantadine. And then finally, there's amantadine extended-release tablets, or Osmolex. Common side effects, like some of the others we talked about, include dizziness, nausea, as well as insomnia, confusion, paranoia, hallucinations. Leg discoloration is one that's kind of unique to amantadine, but you can also have changes in blood pressure or lower blood pressure. So if you already have problems with something like orthostatic hypotension, this drug might be something you really need to watch out for because it could lower your blood pressure more. Some uncommon side effects to really look out for are things like urinary retention, which really puts you at high risk for medical issues, as well as livedo reticularis. That's essentially a lacy purplish discoloration of the skin on the legs, typically associated with a little bit of swelling or edema. It should be noted that occurs in less than 1% of those taking amantadine, so it's pretty rare, but if it does happen, you definitely want to let your physician know. So in my experience, amantadine, whether it's the generic amantadine or the Gocovri, the extended release version, honestly, I haven't had a patient on Osmolex that I know of. But for those that have had Parkinson's disease for many years, especially if you're going to 10 plus years, those that take more and more dopamine over time, those are the folks that have the worst dyskinesias. I've known several people, at least one that I'm treating now as a physical therapist has Gocovri on his list, and it really does help to improve the dyskinesias, especially when you're taking medications as often as every couple of hours. The great thing about the meds like Gocovri is you really only have to take it once a day, and that extended release tends to last that entire period of time, whether it's overnight or during the day. Most commonly, though, people take Gocovri at bedtime. Interestingly enough, amantadine can also help with off times, helping movement to actually happen when you're wearing off of your levodopa. That's about all there is to say about amantadine, but if you're having those dyskinesias, particularly if they're a little bit more severe, more nagging, and they don't seem to really get better, then that's something that you may discuss with your physician, see if something like amantadine could be an option for you. Hope you're enjoying this series as much as I am making it. Look forward to seeing you in the next installment. As always, be empowered.